This is the Singapore Primary Mathematics US Edition Homeschool Math Curriculum. And this is its much less expensive competitor, Singapore Math by Thinking Kids. I've used both curriculums, and while they teach the same method, these books have their differences.
It was the savings of $47 per year, per child, that made me want to try this out.
But the question is the less expensive book just as good? That's what I'm going to talk about today. I have used both for several years, and here's what I think. Now, if you've never heard of Singapore Math, let me give you a short introduction that is on their website. The Singapore Math Method is a highly effective teaching approach originally developed by Singapore's Ministry of Education in the 1980s for Singapore public schools. The method has been widely adopted in various forms around the world over the past 20 years, following the introduction of the curriculum to the US in 1998. I'll link their website below if you want more information. So let's start with the biggest difference between the two curriculums, which is the price. The Singapore Math by Thinking Kids on Amazon has a price range between $9.99 to $14.99. You get one book that is approximately 250 pages that will be used over two semesters of school. Singapore Primary Mathematics comes with four books, two textbooks, and two workbooks that also covers two semesters. Each of these books is about 100 pages. Just as a side note, the level listed on the book will be one number less than the grade level that your child is in. So a level 3 book would be for a 4th grader. A level 5 book would be for a 6th grader. Also take note that the primary mathematics from Singapore Math goes through 6th grade, but the books created by Thinking Kids only go up to 5th grade. Something that I really like about the shorter Thinking Kids version is that it's much simpler. The original version has an entire textbook to teach the kids the different math principles, but Thinking Kids only has maybe a page or half a page of teaching material. This is great when your child is quick to understand math. It's concise and it doesn't repeat itself at all. But if your child needs lots of examples or longer explanations, this might be a negative for you. There is a formula sheet at the beginning of the book and after the mid-year review to help with the explanation, but again, it's very concise. If you're not very confident in teaching math, or your student is not a natural at math, you'll probably find primary mathematics much more helpful. Just something to consider. Thinking Kids also has a lot less math problems. Again, if your child is very good at math and they usually just blow through their math problems, then this book would be perfect for them. No extra busy work. Since I have used both curriculums with my 4 kids, I can say that this was a good thing with some and a bad thing with others. Whenever a concept was more difficult for one of my kids, I would have to search for different ways to supplement the curriculum. With more math problems, or with flashcards, or with what have you. So in that sense, it can mean more work for you to try to teach those more difficult concepts. On the other hand, the long explanations and the pages of math problems from the primary mathematics might seem overwhelming for a child who doesn't enjoy math. Balance is key. Another difference I have found is that with the Thinking Kids version, they have reviews every couple of lessons. This is not how it is with the primary mathematics. I really enjoy using these reviews to see how my child is progressing, to know that they are retaining the information and that it's something that they actually learned and not just got through the problems. Sometimes it's really easy to reproduce the work when it's fresh in your mind. But after a week or so has gone by, you completely forget it. So I've really enjoyed the reviews as tests. I do grade them, but then I get to go back with my child and go over every single question that they get wrong and help them work through it so that they understand what they were supposed to do and why it is that they got that wrong. With the Singapore Math, the original version, they have reviews maybe twice or three times in a semester. So I don't get that review as often to see how my child is progressing. I just wish they would have it at shorter intervals in the primary mathematics like they do in the Thinking Kids. As far as lesson plans, primary mathematics separates their lessons with these little tabs. They tell you when to stop in the textbook and where to go in the workbook to finish the lesson. Now, I use the My Father's World lesson plans, which details what my child needs to do each day. So I don't really use the little tabs, but if I didn't have this and I had to find out my own lesson plans for the math curriculum, those things would be very helpful. Singapore Math does sell a home instructor's guide for about $20 that gives you a word-by-word script. I think that could have been very helpful, and I wish I had it when I was starting out, because some of the things that are taught in the Singapore Method are done in a way that's different than how I learned them. This would have made it a lot easier for me to teach, instead of me first trying to figure out what they were trying to say before I could explain it to my child. So, is the Singapore Math by Thinking Kids just as good as the Singapore Math Primary Mathematics? In my opinion, no. But would I still recommend it? Yes. I think it has its place. If you're new to the Singapore Method, definitely get the original curriculum first. It'll explain it so much better, and they do things a little differently, so it's important to understand what they want you to do and what they want the child to learn. But if you've already done Singapore Math for at least a year, then you may want to try the Thinking Kids version. And it's definitely cheap enough that if partway through you don't like it, you only spent a few bucks. If your child is naturally good at math, the Thinking Kids version really might be the way to go, because it teaches all the same concepts at a faster rate and with much less practice. However, if your child is not a natural, the original, more expensive curriculum is definitely the way to go, because the ultimate goal is for your child to learn. My kids have had good success with this curriculum. Singapore Math is a great way to learn math and to learn how to apply the math to life. Whichever book you choose will be a great choice, and your child's success will be the proof of that. I hope that you've enjoyed this review. There are probably other reviews that are more in depth that you can find, but I really wanted to do the comparison of the two books to help you find which one would be best for your family.
But math isn't the only subject necessary for a great homeschool year. If you're looking for reviews of other curriculum, check out my other videos.
So that's all for today. Have a great week, and I'll see you next time. Bye.